Dr. Richard Carmona, thank you for joining us today. Dr. Carmona is a physician, a police officer, and a public health administrator. So he is a wonderful person for us to talk to about the current situation. He is the 17th Surgeon General of the United States. He is a distinguished professor of public health at the University of Arizona. And he's on many boards, but among them, the Ross University School of Medicine and the Ross University School of Veterinary Medicine, which makes him a part of our Adtalem Global Education family. Dr. Carmona, thank you so much for taking time today. I know that everyone is trying to take your time, so thank you.
Lisa, I'm happy to be with you and address our colleagues at the Adtalem family.
Thank you so much. First question, it's the question I'm sure you've been getting a lot. COVID-19, let's start with fact versus fiction. What should we be doing and what should we not be doing as this situation evolves?
Well, the most important thing to understand for all of us is that this is an infectious disease and it's transmittable. And it's transmittable from us to somebody else. Hence this whole idea of social distancing and as a public health strategy. So the more we can stay away from people who we are uncertain what their contacts were, in other words, going to that concert with 25,000 people, going into a big academic meeting for a grand rounds with 300 people, you don't know. Even though they look healthy today, you don't know who has been infected. They could be carriers and shedding virus. So we're trying to restrict our movements so that we will push the curve down and this way stop this virus early and so it doesn't go on and because we keep transmitting it.
So the more that each of us individually and with our families, children, et cetera, practice social distancing, the better we are in terms of a community.
Absolutely. And that means, but also wash your hands. Yes. If you feel like you've got a cold, sneezing, coughing, do it in an appropriate manner, you know, using the arm up, handkerchief, tissues, throw them away appropriately. Make sure you're wiping down all the surfaces in your work and in your home areas. So these are simple things that we can do. If you must travel and you're on a plane, wipe everything down. Try not to go off long distances. If you can travel in a car and that you know that's yours, you're probably safer for shorter trips and so on. These are just simple public health messages that we talk about in flu season every year.
Right.
Nothing changed.
It's been heightened. Yes. Got it. So shifting gears a little bit, as you know, but others may not know, Adtalem graduates more nurses and physicians than any other organization in the U.S. What can we do as educators to support our alumni as they're serving in the healthcare system? I'm sure the healthcare system is getting stretched right now. What can we do to be helpful?
Well, I think that's a great question. And I look at our alumni with a term we use in the military called force multipliers. Okay. The fact that coming from you, our leader, asking them to be part of a bigger team that helps to make their community safe, take the leadership, our Ross graduates from veterinary school, from medical school, because this is about One Health. This is about the mixing of the human and the animal population that we've talked about for so many years, where Adtalem really takes the lead globally because of our positioning. And so let's reach out to those folks who understand this better than most, ask them in their communities. Pass the message along. Let's see if we can be that force multiplier that helps to diminish the spread of that virus.
I like that force multiplier. And speaking of that, we also have many current students at Chamberlain University at the nursing school. A lot of those students are pursuing their graduate degrees as they are currently health professionals working in these hospital systems and clinics right now. Any tips for them as they navigate this situation?
Absolutely. First, your own personal hygiene in school. We want to keep you at school. We want you to graduate on time. So make sure you stay healthy. But all of you have families, you have friends, and they may not be in your discipline. So be the health advocate for your network of people. Make sure they're practicing all those good health practices, and you then can help to diminish the spread of this disease.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And for us at Chamberlain, and really across our medical and healthcare institutions, one of the things that we have going for us is that we've always done online education. You know, so we've got faculty that are trained to do that. And that's really helpful in these times, because I do think that the way that online education and training is thought about, both in the U.S. and globally, will change in a positive way as a result of this. But other changes I'm thinking about that you might have a little bit more of a sense of, as you know, Adtalem's a workforce solutions provider. So in the healthcare space, we're trying to provide solve complex problems for these hospital systems. How do you see the workforce needs, you know, looking out ahead a bit past the current crisis, how do you see those workforce needs of hospital systems changing as a result of this coronavirus?
Well, the fact is hospitals are changing, health systems are changing, it's all evolving, even without the coronavirus. We see the practice patterns changing and so on. So we prepare our students for that. But hospitals are part of an ecosystem that surge when we need support for what we call all hazards preparedness. That is nuclear, biological, chemical, terrorist events, earthquakes, tsunamis. When we frame the national response framework, we put all hazards there because the day that we spoke about this, we had a finite amount of threats that we identified. But in the future, we don't know what those new threats will be, like coronavirus. When this plan was done a decade and a half ago, nobody knew about coronavirus mutating and causing this problem. So under this plan, we can frame any and all threats today or in the future. Hospitals become a very important part. Workforce becomes a very important part. Because as the disease increases in our community, we have to surge. That means we need more beds. We need more EMTs. We need more paramedics. We need more nurses. We need more therapists. Well, where do they put them? If the hospital is full, how do we then surge? And that's mutual aid agreements. It's being able to redistribute the population. But all of our students should learn this because no matter where they end up, they will be part of the solution as long as they have the information.
Got it. Excellent. Excellent advice. And I've got to ask you this. Obviously, by now, people can tell you are an expert in disaster medicine. You've seen many tough medical situations across the globe. How do you rate the United States in terms of our resiliency and ability to handle this COVID-19 situation?
Well, I think that as far as resilience goes, the U.S. is a very, very resilient country. As it relates specifically here, I think that public is uncertain what's going on. There's been mixed messages given by people who meant well but didn't understand the gravity of the situation and that their words have distinct meaning. Yes. You never tell people it's going to be all right if things are going to change for the worse. And so being able to tell the people the truth, be transparent, but give them solutions and give them something to empower them that they can control their environment. That's what the public wants. So false claims and things like that that may be well-meaning to calm them down, that doesn't help. So it's about messaging, appropriate messaging, basically transparency and simple solutions that they can do where they can feel better. You know, I had a lady call me the other day and said, does this mean I can't hug my children anymore? I said, no. And explained to her what's going on. She says, okay, now I understand. But make sure you keep your children close to you, that they're not out in the street running around where you don't know where they are, because all of us can become vectors, okay? It's okay in your circle, in your home. When we say, social distancing and don't be in groups more than 10, yes, but most of those 10 you don't know. You're in a store shopping and they all come in. If it's your household where you live and these are the people you know and their patterns of movement have been controlled, you're pretty safe. We're not asking you to, leave your family. But for the average person, they're scared. They say, oh, my God, I can't be with my kids. I can't do this. I can't do that. When they understand the reason is that each of us can be a vector, that each of us has to take responsibilities to not contact anybody outside who could be sick. If we do, if they have a fever, if they're sick, if you have a fever sick, there are things you should do so that you can isolate yourself, quarantine yourself in your home, to make sure that you don't get that disease. So uncertainty in our society can be as toxic as the virus itself because of mental health problems, suicide rates that may go up and things like that where people feel despondent. And it's up to us, it's up to our students and our faculty at Adtalem Properties to be able to be that adult in the room, that calm person that says, hey, talk to me. Let me explain to you what's going on here. Let me give you some opportunities to provide solutions in your community. I mean, that's what we're all about.
I am so glad you said that, because that's exactly the messaging that Adtalem Global has been putting out there across our institutions and companies, which is really, we're trying to balance between obviously transparent information. We're always going to talk to our students, our faculty, our colleagues about what's going on. This is not our first crisis, but certainly on this global scale, we have to think about all of the interests and stakeholders, et cetera. And at the same time, just it's really important for us as a medical and healthcare organization and as an education institution to continue with business as usual as much as we can and understand what we can control and can't control. It's funny you say 10 people. As you know, I have a first grader, Grace, and first graders don't practice social distance.
A lot of high fives and hugging.
She can't go on play dates because that's just not what they do. Yep. And so we have to understand, right, who we're talking about, et cetera, as we protect ourselves and our families. And for us, our communities, which is both our campuses as well as the communities that we serve.
Yes.
Dr. Carmona, I am just honored that you would take time when you're getting calls from the highest levels to talk to us. We appreciate your role on our board of ROS, both the School of Medical and Veterinary Medicine. And we know that you are going to be right in the midst of helping the U.S. and the globe get past this. We know that we will get past this, but in the meantime, Adtalem Global Education is going to do our part with your help and the part of our directors and trustees to make that happen. So thank you for your time today.
Lisa, thank you for your leadership and bringing us all together. And one last message I say to go out to all of our colleagues, when you're going to speak, think about what you're saying and make sure you are informing and not inflaming.
Oh, I love it. We will take that moving forward, Dr. Carmona. Informing and not inflaming and force multiplier are going to be words of the week. Thank you.